tutorials cover a comprehensive overview of Final Cut Pro. If you just want the essentials in a shorter time frame, click the I above for a 20-minute tutorial called The Essentials on Learning Final Cut. There's also free course material you can download using a link in the description below. Uncompress the zip file that downloads to your computer. There are two folders, one's called Sample Media, and that contains video, audio, photos to use with the tutorials. The other folder, called Completed Library, contains completed edits of each lesson, so you can check your progress as you go through the tutorials. Double-click the library called Completed Lesson from the Completed Library folder in the Finder. Let's look at the Final Cut Pro window, which is divided into three main workspaces. On the upper left is where you organize your media. To the right of that is the viewer that plays your video clips. And the bottom area is for editing. That's known as the timeline. The top left shows the library sidebar. This is where you organize and manage your libraries and events. To explain, a library could be compared to a whole TV series, and the event would then be each individual episode of that full TV series. Final Cut will open for the first time with an untitled library and also with an event inside that library that has the day's date. Your first assignment is to name these so you can find them later. For convenience, name both the same and call them First Edit. You'll see more about libraries and events in the next tutorial when you import the media that you download. This is what Final Cut looks like when media has been imported and added to a project. You'll see how to do this in the next tutorial. To the right of the library sidebar is the browser, currently showing the footage as film strips. You'll see later how to view this as a list of clips, if that's your preference. You can skim through imported media in the browser, and that will show you the footage to add to your movie. As you skim, the media shows in the viewer to the right. Photos and iTunes can be accessed by clicking this button, and you can find pre-installed titles and cool animations, that's generators, with this button. The timeline at the bottom is a space that holds all your projects. It can hold any number of projects. You assemble your video in a project by adding clips from the browser. The clips in the project appear sequentially and they can be trimmed and reorganized. You can also add effects, transitions, titles, and generators. You can access these effects and generators by clicking these buttons, which will allow you to add them to the clips in your project. You'll see to add these in a further tutorial. And when you've got more than one project in the timeline, they can be brought into view by using these previous and next arrows, just as you move backwards and forwards in Safari. You can modify the clips and effects within a project in the Inspector. When a clip is selected in the project, click this button to open the Inspector. This will also let you make color corrections and adjust the audio, both its volume and modify audio effects. To make the Inspector appear full height, double-click the bar at the top. Click it again to collapse. You can export, or that's share your edited video, by selecting the button at the far right at the top. You'll look at that in much more detail in a later session. You now need to import the media that you've downloaded from my site, and that'll be in the next tutorial.